a journey, traveling the country and experiencing creativity and art demonstrations. And now, we're live in a city near you, whoever you might be. It's the Kraaft It Live Art Concert, an art show with fun, laughter, and a few mistakes thrown in too. Follow along on Instagram and see behind-the-scenes images by D-Dog. Fielding your YouTube questions, Sylvia and Mr. Crafter. And now, your host, Heather Crafter.
Hello, welcome to Kraaft It Live. Hopefully you guys can hear me okay. We had a little bit of technical difficulties with getting the camera set up, but at least this camera works, so that part's good. Every once in a while, you know, there's like those things called updates and junk, and it throws a little curveball into the live streaming action, but ain't nothing gonna stop my arting jive. Crickets. I hear nothing but crickets. That's all right. All right, so we're live, and we are having a great time already so far. So Sylvia's here, and Sylvia?
Yes.
Sylvia's here, and she is ready to do something. I don't know. Say hi to the audience. Why don't we do
okay,
that?
Okay, I'll say hi to the audience. Okay. So Kim is here, bright and early. We have BJ, and Abe is almost always with me, so hopefully he is today. But if not, we miss you, Abe. We'll see you next time. And then we have Mary Crochet, and we have Michael. Michael is here, and I called him Road Kale. So that's your new name today instead of Michael Ann's name being changed.
Mokale?
Yeah.
Mokale.
And then Aurora is here. And let me see if anybody else has joined. Liz is here, and Tracy is here, and Anumati is here.
Yay.
No, you're not late, Anumati. You're just in time.
You're
sweetheart.
Not late.
No,
not at all.
No.
No.
Oh, and we have New York style nails and glitz.
Oh my gosh,
cool.
Really?
I love that.
Well, welcome, welcome. All right, everybody. So today's show is. Oh, I forgot about the.
I need my.
The today's message. There it is.
Okay, today's message is, see, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey. Zechariah 9:9. Hosanna,
yeah.
Save us, Lord, we need your gentle love. Oh,
you know,
yes.
You know what I love about that scripture from Zechariah is that that is fulfilled in Christ, because Christ fulfilled those words. So it's like early, old prophecy fulfilled in Christ. That's what I love.
That's
about
cool.
That one. So happy to see that. Okay, so what we have this week is the insane. I don't feel like a full deck today. You ever feel like a few cards
shy
of a full deck?
That's what I'm. My deck is always empty.
Yeah, that's what I'm feeling like today. So this is pretty appropriate. We have this deck of cards. We went camping as a family a couple weeks ago, and we went to play cards, and this deck of cards was there and missing a few, and it's like stuck together. Look at this. Look at this. So then I'm like, this is garbage. We can't play cards with it, but don't throw it away. I'm going to use it on the show. So that's what we did. That's what we're doing. That's what we're here to do today.
Cool.
So I've got, I'm not going to do them all though, but I do want to have a king in there and an ace. All right. So let's do this many for now. Maybe we'll do more. I don't know. All right, we're going to do backside, front side, doesn't matter. And we're just going to mix media, go crazy, have fun, try a few different techniques. Before the show, I was doing some jelly plating. Can you guys see all that? I don't know if you can see that or not.
Wow, I love the colors in that.
Isn't that pretty?
Oh, my goodness.
Look at this one. These are labels.
I was wondering what they were.
Yeah, I can't use them for anything else. So I jelly plated on them. And
well, are they return labels or what?
They're just like product labels from when we had the store. You know, can you kind of see the craft shop logo in there?
I did a kiss segment on reusing your labels.
Yeah, and so these were
that. Yeah.
And like this was a sheet of labels that didn't get utilized. This is big labels.
Those are cool.
So look at that. Okay, watch. This is the best part about using labels. And I didn't fully cover this one, but who cares, right? So we just take, oh, these are name tags, so they're done a little differently. If I can get it right. Come on. You know, when you want to show something.
Well, it's the nails, too. So.
No, the nails aren't the problem. It's how that comes apart. What I wanted to show you was that, I had already done it. Yeah, that's not what I wanted to do. So, so you know how you have like a border around all of these?
Yes.
That's what I was trying to show you, is that if you take the border off, then you're left with a really clean label. You're left with clean labels.
Off, you got still a clean label.
I'm saying a clean sheet of labels. Never mind. Goodness gracious. So, but I did this with old ones, so you can see that I've printed onto the label sheet. You see that, right?
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. So, anyway, we're going to use those as a part of all this stuff. Some of them have my address on them, so I got to be careful that I definitely covered those.
Oh, Linz is here. Yay, finally. But she says she's not, but she is. We can see her.
We can see her even though she's not.
And okay. Tracy Kiger's here, and Creative Wings is here. And
welcome.
Bill does Belize. Oh, our Belize guy is here. Hi.
You know what?
It's been a while.
That's Pantsless Bill. Welcome, Pantsless Bill. We're glad you're here. All right, I've got some white gesso. You know, people ask all the time, what kind of gesso are you using? It doesn't matter. Just put something on. What is... Dina Wakely says, you know, all gessos are equal. And I don't necessarily agree with that per se, but I definitely say it doesn't matter. You use what you have. If you don't have one and you're looking for a good one, then ask yourself a couple of questions. Do you want it to have full coverage, or do you want it to have just a little bit? Hey, you guys, somebody just showed up.
Yay!
Nikki's in the house.
Nikki's here. Nikki's in the house.
Hello.
Beautiful Nikki.
Hugs to you, Nikki. I'm busy.
Thank you. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
Never late. And so, Heather, you're talking about using different gessos and stuff. Can you explain a little about the applicator that you're using?
Yeah, this is out of the kitchen department at Walmart for 88 cents.
I just love that.
It's just a silicone rubber spatula. Works really good, though.
Yes, it does. I'm watching you.
And 88 cents is way better than those catalysts that we saw.
Oh, my God, those catalysts
in the art store.
Are so expensive. Yeah.
Yeah.
See, so like when she was, go back to when she was saying, you use what you got, people.
Yeah. Use what you got. Well, actually, I bought this for this purpose because I could use this on the jelly plate. It's safe for the jelly plate. And it was 88 cents. Do I need to say that part again? Because it was 88 cents. That's the really important part. So I'm going to clean that off. Look at that. Cleaning that off just right there on the card. Done. And then I'm going to go into the crackle glaze because kind of want to have this stuff on ASAP.
So it can start crackling.
Yeah, so it'll start crackling. But now that I've said that, all right, bear with me. I'm working out of order. So exciting to have Nikki here. Let's see. I have some, like, what are these things? So an old friend sent these. This is from, I don't, you guys remember, oh my gosh, her name is just escaped me. Beth.
Oh.
Beth, who lived in Canada?
Yeah.
Yeah, these are from her. So they're actually German. It's a German book page.
Oh, cool.
Isn't that neat? So this is matte medium. Again, matte mediums are the same. You know, it's really, it's again about, well, what do you want? What do you want to do with it?
Andrew says he loves the shade of pink on Heather's nail. Yeah, I agree. Her nails look really cool. Mine, however, are springtime in the desert. Woohoo!
Springtime in the desert. What the heck is that?
It's the bright yellow green we see on all our beautiful
gotcha.
Trees, followed by the blue sky.
Gotcha.
Wow.
I can't believe I asked. My bad.
My gosh.
My
Not
bad.
As though it's the first time here, lady.
I know, right?
Right. And then, okay, I don't know New York style nails and glitz. We got to have your name. But she says, uh-oh, her battery is dying. She's going to run. And she's got a bunch of little feet.
Oh, that's too funny.
To her charger.
Oh, she's getting her charger. So yeah. She's not leaving us.
No,
she's
not leaving.
All right, so you can probably see what I'm doing here slightly. I'm working pretty darn fast, but that's because we have 1 hour to get all of these things done. So I want to show you that it doesn't take much time to do a little bit of mixed media. And you can do a little bit, because this is, people say all the time, what is that canvases that we worked on? Like, oh my gosh, we did that whole big, huge canvas. And people were like, that's too big. I could never do that. Well, playing cards are pretty darn small. And that's a pretty nice...
They're so cool. I love them. And I think I shared last week that I did a booklet where I did once a month some kind of nice verse and put it together and sent it to my daughter. For January, did a verse that, pertained to January, February, about love and loving her as my daughter and that kind of stuff. And put them together, bound them and put them together. And they're just the coolest little thing. These cool playing cards.
That's a cool idea. Now, I have printed out, like, this week, without saying it, giving away too many details, but this week has been a little stressful. The last, 6 months have been incredibly stressful. So I've been kind of freaking lately. And I got up yesterday and printed out, I'm going to show you guys, printed out Psalm 118 like this in columns, and see how it's the verses are like this, right? So I can trim this out and put them on my cards.
Oh, cool.
So I was thinking maybe I'd make a little booklet, or maybe I wouldn't. Maybe I'd just send them out to people, like send a card out,
yeah.
All right, I'm going to dry this before we go much further. Is any other comments you want to bring up while I'm being obnoxious with my
New
sound?
York style. I just love it. New York style, nails and glitz. She says, by the way, you can call me New York, or my name is Tanya. I'm going to go with Tanya, but let's just,
Thank you, Tanya, for letting us know your name is Tanya. See, yeah. I've said it a few times. We'll remember. Appreciate it.
And then they're talking about Michael saying he enjoys drinking and getting thrown out with homeless drunks. I don't know what
this
is all about.
All right.
But it has something to do with Kim's husband, because he plays in a band.
Oh, yeah. If you follow Kim on Instagram, you get to see sometimes pictures she shares of that.
Yeah, I guess it was a fun time in the bar the other night. So
I believe that.
Yeah.
That's for a live chat only. If you know what's really interesting, though, if you're watching this in replay, the chat should pop up and you should be able to see what they're talking about.
Yeah.
Warning. For those who are chatting. All right, so I've just put a little bit more gesso over the top, but you notice I didn't do everything, because the beauty of playing cards.
Did you put the crackle glaze down?
No, not
yet.
Not yet. The beauty of playing cards is that they already have backgrounds.
Yeah.
So it's not like a little white pieces of card, which you could do that if you don't have playing cards that you want to destroy. I mean, make better. Right?
Right?
You could do that. You could cut up pieces of mixed media paper and do this. So people are like, oh, I wish I had a deck of cards. You don't need a deck of cards.
And Freedom Deep has joined us. Everybody's saying hi to Freedom.
Hello, hello. Welcome. All right. Now I'm going to do the crackle glaze, okay? And this is what I'm going to do with it. I'm using the same tool, by the way. That 88 cents is going a long way today. Just touching spots here and there on each of these cards, and it's really just a mess, and that's okay. And then we're going to heat it with the heat tool again, because we can, because this is a 1 hour show and we are not going to be here for 3 hours today.
Yeah, and then by hitting it with the heat gun, the crackle is finer than if
not with this particular stuff.
Not? Oh, okay.
No, it's different than the Prima.
Generally, if you
it's about thin or thick application that makes it thin or thick lines.
Cool.
Yeah.
So what kind was that? Is that
this
DecoArt?
Is the DecoArt media line. It's
They have great products, DecoArt.
What I'm loving about their media line is that everything works every time. Yeah. I've had crackle glazes and crackle paints and things that didn't necessarily work, and you don't use them up, and then they're garbage.
Right.
This has not been the case. This is probably my fourth one of these, because I love this product so much. And we're not even on the screen. So this is the product I was talking about right here. So see how it's bubbling and stuff? I'm going a little crazy with it, but I love that texture that happens. Ooh, crackle.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold that. Let me get a side picture of that, because that'll show them what you're talking about.
This is doing more than just crackle.
Smelling too.
Ooh. Yeah, you're not really supposed to do this with it, but...
Oh, that is too cool.
I like the textures that are created when you use your heat tool. You're not supposed to do that, by the way, but, you know, it can. Usually I use the other heat tool and it's a little less intense. Somebody said they have a drawer full of cards, so whip them out, play along, snap a shot, and send it on Instagram. Share with the rest of us. All right, so we're just going to move on. This is going to dry some more as we're going, but we're going to move on. Okay. What I would suggest, though, that if you have the time and patience, that you use, you let that air dry, you know, the crackle paste, or paint, in this one, glaze. All right. So I'm using, and you notice that I probably, it looks like I glued these together, but all I did was just overlap, so that way I had a little less gluing to do, a little less tedious gluing to do. Does that make sense? Nikki, can you see from where you are? Because we didn't get you set up properly before you got here. Ooh, look at that one with the texture. You see that?
Yeah, it's cool.
Push that around in there. All right, so we got four with that green on there. Oh, we got one extra one, so it makes like weird number, an odd number, huh? And you see how precise I'm being with the color application? You do see that, right? Using my favorite tool, the finger. And I am going into that not yet dry crackle paint glaze. Call it what it is.
They're talking, remember how Kim has got that room in her house where she put the game boards on the ceiling with game pieces and stuff, and she's saying that she has a drawer full of cards, and Lynn's is saying, you mean they're not on your roof and the tables, the walls, whatever?
Exactly,
so,
right.
So now they're coming with ideas, and Lynn's is saying a card lamp to go with the game board ceiling. I think that'd be a great idea.
All right, this is like a purple, metallic purple.
Lisa is here. Hi, Lisa.
Hi, Lisa. Lisa's been doing a lot of videos. Have you seen that? Have you seen that Lisa's doing videos?
Mm-mm, no.
You should check them out.
I have to check them out. Check out Lisa's videos, everybody.
Yeah, over on YouTube, right where you're watching us now. Click on her... Is she signed in as Lisa's Eclectic Life? Yep. Okay, so click on her image there, and you will go to her YouTube channel. You know, after the show, do it after the show if you don't mind.
Yeah.
stay here at least while we're playing around, right? Some great videos though. Lots of folks doing videos in our community, and that's so fun. All right, there we go. Let's see, what's another color we can do for this one? I'm thinking like a peach.
Oh, peach would be pretty.
Or a
yeah.
teal. Which one? Peach or teal?
Do peach. Make it nice and light.
All right, let's do this one peach and the other one teal.
Okay.
So we got both. And in between, I am wiping my finger on my apron, if you're wondering how I'm not mixing the colors. That's how. All right, we're going to let that. We're going to let that one just dry a little bit before I get into the next thing here. I'm cleaning off my very expensive tool. And you know, you can do both sides, because if you turn it into a booklet, mm-hmm. or you can glue them side, you know, back to back, so you have a little bit more sturdy.
When I made that booklet too. For my daughter, I decorated the one side, and on the other side I put the verse.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Very cool. And which did you do, the numbers or the...
It, by the time I got them all covered with stuff, I couldn't tell you which
oh,
side
okay.
was which. Yeah.
Do you know what I was going to do? Probably not. Teal on
no,
this
one. No, tell me what you were going to do.
I don't know. Okay. That's why I was asking. All right. We're going to use this one. It's a peacock
oh,
pearl.
Metallic. Yeah. Oh,
yes. Yeah. Can't go wrong there, right? So, oh, you know what I did want to talk about? We have a newsletter, finally. For those of you who have signed up for the newsletter in the past at Craft Shaak, you may know that I took quite a long time off, way more time than I had anticipated I would. And I finally got back into it again last week. And I decided that as of this week, so they go out, it goes out every week on Fridays, and as of this week, it will have, we will start doing a video chat like I used to. You know how I used to do like the little mm-hmm. chat with me, coffee moments type thing? That's what we're going to see in the next one. So I'm liking this one. Mm-hmm. This one's getting a little bit of everybody on there, huh? That's turned out pretty cool. I don't know why, but these colors are pretty close to my favorites. Let's look at this one. This one needs... I think it needs a little bit of that teal, too. Just a little, though. Don't go crazy, Heather. Show some restraint. Oh, that's comedy right there. Comedy.
Speaking of awesome newsletters, you know, Lynn's is... if you guys have not signed up for her newsletter, you have got to go to her website and sign up for her newsletter. It's an amazing newsletter. It covers all sorts of cool topics, and then there's a actual cartoon strip of Hammy, and I don't mean Hammy stripping. I mean it's a cartoon thing, because no
great.
One lives.
YouTube
you know.
Just sent up
yeah,
red flags on our channel,
yeah.
just like that. Okay, that's a pretty good base. They look pretty decent. Some of that crackling is starting to happen there a little
I
bit.
I guess Cosmo's climbing the curtain, so Lynn says, don't do anything. Wait, I'll be right back.
Don't do anything. Sure.
Oh, Sandra's here. Hi, Sandra.
Yay. Sure, we won't do anything.
And Creative Wings is saying, it's a lovely mess. That it is.
All right, the next thing I want to do is sprays. And I have to dig into the bin that I hadn't opened yet in order to do the sprays. And I'm thinking we need this yellow one. My headset falls whenever I try to do this.
Well, because you have slippery hair. Nice and shiny, slippery hair.
It's called it's called gravity. Everything on me is sliding
gravity.
Off.
No, we don't want to talk about gravity. It's not been kind to me.
That's a whole nother show.
You can sign up for Heather's newsletter on her website, which is kraaftjack.com.
There's actually a link in the description. Yeah, there's a link in the description called Linktree, and there it has all of our links in one place, including the sign up for the newsletter.
There you go. I stand corrected. Okay. In the description of this video, find Linktree. In Linktree, she has a link to every place that you can find her.
All right, so plan B on the sprays, because they're clogged and I didn't have time to mess with anything because of our technical difficulties, I'm unable to get that out. Oh, that's funny. You didn't see that.
Nope.
All right. I really want to spray, though, because I have this beautiful mask. You see this?
It's
this
so
butterfly
pretty.
Mask?
Yeah.
We got these when we went, or I bought these when we went to Jerry's Artorama.
That was on our journey.
Yes.
And I absolutely insist on using them. Darn it.
Use the jelly plate to get that imprint.
I could, I guess. But I don't want to cover the whole thing. I just wanted it to be a mist. So let's see what we do here. All right, I got this Hansa yellow light. And it should be somewhat transparent.
No, I don't do videos on YouTube anymore. I'm sorry. I got a lot out there on my channel. It's Tabor Original. And there's a...
Yeah, can you put the link to it in there?
Oh, sure.
Thank you.
No, I can't.
They're looking. Come on. They want to go see. She's got some great tips over there about keeping it simple. We have a playlist about it, too, but I don't know where that's at.
Yeah, let me see if I can find it.
This is sort of not the way to do this, by the way. Yeah, that worked terribly. Pretend that worked great, will you? Hey, let's not waste that, though, because part of my problem is I don't have the foam underneath there to use it like a stamp.
Oh, good. Look at that. I have 1,800 subscribers. Oh, my gosh.
You didn't even know?
No, I did.
That's
not
hilarious.
Know. That's so bad. Oh, my gosh.
All right. You got to see this. This is a piece of tissue paper that was sent to me by an incredibly awesome viewer that has these different things on it.
This looks like a weird link.
I don't know if you guys can see it. I don't think you guys
can see
it.
Are they that weird looking?
Everything is weird. I don't know. That didn't really come off there like I wanted, but you know what will be cool is to add this on here.
Okay, we'll give this a try and see.
All right. Give that a try and see then. All right, let's get out our matte medium again. And you know what? I think I need a brush for this. No, this will work.
It says view as a subscriber. That's not right. That shouldn't be on there, right? I don't think so either.
Oh, I love this.
We'll give that a try and see what that
does. That's fun. So now, that deli paper with that yellow pattern on there. And it's not just yellow pattern. There's also, I don't know if you guys could see that. Yeah, that bird stencil that was put on there. That was from Awesome Viewer, who added this in a box she sent me. So let's just put this on here. And because it's deli paper, you'll see the other layers underneath it as well. So exciting. And what I love about doing this type of thing is that it builds up the strength of the card, too. So if you have these flimsy, cheap cards from the dollar store, never fret. Just keep adding layers. I'm loving that. I can't wait till that one dries, because the layers coming through it are pretty cool. Yeah. Let's put this over here. Let's just do it like that. Can you see what I'm doing? Yeah, okay. So, I was talking about the newsletter and how we're going to be doing a video chat thing. And in the past, you used to be able to find that video chat on my YouTube channel, but I'm not going to do that anymore. The only place you can find that coffee morning chat time is with our newsletter. So keep that in mind. This is stamped on here. I think I'm going to add this to one of these other ones. I'm just going to keep adding layers until I'm happy with these. And don't let them dry.
I love the colors in this one. The size of the playing cards is the same as ATCs. I don't know.
I mean, you got to be careful because some ATCs. Sandra taught me this, but some ATC clubs that like you can, you know how you can swap cards or whatever with people.
Yeah.
Some of them are really particular about the sizes. They have to be.
Was it
the
two
right
and a half
size?
By 3 or something like that?
Yeah, ATCs are 2.5 by 3.5.
Yeah.
And these cards are dun 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 dun, just under 3.5, and just under 2.5. So they would be pretty crabby about these, but they would work for me. So.
Yeah.
But some of those groups would be crabby about it.
And I know
and
cards
are
in
different
size
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
You know,
so. Could you imagine one of those little mini decks of mm-hmm. cards? That would be fun. Incredibly frustrating, I think. but you could.
Size. Yeah.
But you know, you could if you were smart about it. See, this is now I'm getting all excited. Let's let these dry and we'll play around a little bit. So you could move these out of my way here. Okay. You could put like. All of your cards, and if you had those minis, this would be really important. Put your cards all side by side, right? And then work on it like it's one unit. You could even tape on the back side and make it one unit and then cut it apart.
Yeah,
oh, tape!
Like
that's another thing you could do.
No, wait.
Tape is another layer you can add. So now I want to start these because those are drying. So see? This could be a whole nother layer. You don't have to. And go in different directions. Right? Let that texture be on there even. Ooh, I like that. Let's add some more.
Yeah.
Let's get absurd about it.
She's adding some texture there, people.
I do like that. That's going to be cool. Okay. Then let's do, what did you say, Nikki? Then you can fold it. Look at that. You already have a little booklet.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Look at that.
Look at that. I was thinking of cutting them apart, but you don't even have to. All right. With this one. See what we get here. Are you guys warm? I'm always hot, so I never know if anybody else is, if it's just me.
Nikki says she doesn't know what she is.
I'm so out of it. I thought the show started at 12. I mean, I'm just.
Oh, you know what? Talk about time show difference change
yeah,
stuff. Okay.
Yeah.
No worries. So,
that's all that Greek celebrating
I know,
you've been doing,
too much
you know.
Greek celebrating.
Well, I started with advertising for the show, and I did it on Mountain Time, I did it on Arizona Time, but I used Mountain Time Tool. So everything was an hour off today. So if you got the notification saying we're live in 10 minutes, like an hour and 10 minutes early, that was my fault. I did that. Me. I'm the one to blame.
I'm just driving along the 202, and I'm like, wait a minute. I'm supposed to be there. No cops around. We're good.
I was just gonna say, Kraaft Shack does not condone speeding.
Oh, you live out here, you have to. If you don't, they just blow you off the road. It's so sad.
Oh, I know. I have Montana license plates on my car, you know?
Mm-hmm.
They don't like that around here.
Well, I think because I have the New York Giants stickers, I'm just a target.
I bet you they don't even look at that. They see the license plate and run away. Oh, do you really?
Ooh,
oh, that's interesting.
For them. I'm like, I'm from New Jersey.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Conversation started at the gas station.
That's funny. Well, yeah, at the gas station, you're sitting still.
Well, I still sit in the car waiting for someone to pump my gas.
I don't think they even have stations like that out here anymore.
Not out here,
No, I don't think so. Yeah.
There's no gas attendant coming in Arizona.
Yeah.
That's funny. And didn't we're talking about the? I don't know if you guys can hear Nikki at all or not, but we're talking about self gas. What do you call that? Self serve or full service? As she's talking about, she still sits and waits for full service. Attendant to come and fill the gas. And what's funny is wasn't like Oregon just recently in the news for that about getting rid of it, and the people were just going nutso.
My parents still don't pump their gas. They wait for me to do it because they just gave up.
I was gonna say I'll be honest with you, I don't pump my gas either. I mean, this is not happening. I'm not living in a house with a bunch of guys on my own. No, not gonna happen. Sorry.
Freedom is saying, Heather, you make mixed media look so effortless. She does. I agree. It's amazing.
Well, I appreciate you saying that. I will tell you this. We've got a blog hop coming up. If you haven't seen an announcement, there's this huge mixed media blog hop where a bunch of ladies, and I think there might even be a couple guys. I don't remember. But there are a ton of artists, mixed media artists, that are going to be putting together some mixed media art. Videos. It's all video. You're going to want to check that out. It's on April 20th. Take a look. Again, subscribe to that newsletter. You will definitely get the announcement and all the information there. And there's going to be tons of giveaways. I just found out yesterday all the things are given away. Holy smokes. Every single stop will get prizes.
Really?
Yep. It's crazy. You gotta check out this blog.
Oh my gosh! I usually don't follow those things.
I don't either, but I was. I mean, it was a big surprise to be invited to something like that. And then when I saw the people involved, I was like, "And I'm pretty sure I'm in the wrong room."
Wow.
But they assured me that I was supposed to be there, so that was good. But I've got a surprise about what I'm doing with mine. The surprise is, you'll have to turn in to see, but pretty much I'll help you make your mixed media look effortless, too. That's my plan. All right, I've got to add pink to this because I just loved how these turned out over here.
Yeah, that's
so pretty. I think I've just got to add some pink. And, I mean, it's the Kraaft Shack.
Sometimes just that little pop of color is all you need.
Well, and it's the Kraaft Shack. I don't do anything without pink. Anyway.
Okay, so you sold Freedom on it. She goes, awesome. I'll get signed up for that newsletter. Yay.
Oh, okay. Awesome. Very cool.
And they're still talking about pumping gas, and Linz is saying that they haven't had people pump petrol or diesel in this country for years. That ended when small garages got out by others. So.
Oh, I will tell you, this is hilarious. My dad recently, we're having conversations because we've been camping and we're talking about going camping again at the end of the month and all the stuff that we've been doing, right? And he calls it petrol.
Your dad?
My dad.
Your dad.
I'm like, what? Where did that come from? Like, that's not normal.
Gosh.
That's not normal.
Petrol, you're kidding me.
No, I'm not kidding you. It's hilarious. But
does he know Linz?
I was thinking that. Huh. I was thinking about asking.
Linz, what have you been up to?
Yeah, have you been talking to my dad? He knows who Linz is. I show him her cartoons all the time. Okay, I love this, and let me show you why. Look at that.
Oh, look at the shimmer.
We're going to have to add a little bit more shimmer because I just can't let go. I can't stop. Okay.
Lisa's saying they haven't had full-service gas stations since the 80s. Really?
What? Yeah, I think that's...
I love New Jersey.
Well, you can love New Jersey and still say they're lazy. It's okay.
Well,
Nobody can hear you until, yeah, nobody can hear you until I repeat what you say. So okay. It's all good. It's all good. You're among friends anyway. It's all good. Oh my gosh, these are my favorites. So it's almost like I had to warm up and now I'm starting to get there, right? Sometimes you have to let yourself. That's today's tip.
The flow.
Today's tip is let yourself have a few practices, right?
There you go.
Today's tip. All right. Okay, so I am going to, I don't know where I want to go from here. This is where I'm stuck a little bit. That's kind of why I put these guys aside. Thought we'd see what happened. Let's cut them apart and see what they look like individually. And then I think we're going to add some black, because at this point, at this stage of the game, I want focal points and details. So like I've gotten this far. This isn't really dry yet. Gotten this far. It's basically just a mishmash of layers at this stage of the game.
Bill is saying that there's no such thing as self-service. I call them no service. What do they have in Belize, Bill?
They don't have cars in Belize.
Yeah, I've been there.
Somebody else has to drive.
Barren,
and it's usually a bus or a taxi cab.
My parents still talk about full service. They used to check your gas. They used to check your tires.
Oh, yeah.
In New York.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah, they wash your windows, they check your wiper fluid, they check your oil, they check your transmission.
Yep.
The only thing I know about full service gas stations is Mayberry. That's it. That's the only example I have of it. I'm not of the generation to have ever experienced such things.
Oh, that's so cool, Lisa, because you have just inspired her. She's in big capital letters. I am going to do some practicing on ATCs later today. I've never made one.
You're kidding me. Girl, okay, ATC swap at the Kraaft Shaak. We got to have one.
Right.
We got to have one. Wouldn't that be so cool? Everybody makes some ATCs, like we'll set a number, and then you send one of your ATCs, each one of your ATCs that you make, to the people on the list, and then they all send to you, so you end up with the same number of ATCs,
right.
But they're all different.
I know. I love that. I've done ATC swaps like that, and I love it.
You know what I should do next time on next week's show? I should make my ATC book cover.
There you go.
Oh.
There you go. T-Dog's. Oh, it's all full service in Belize.
What?
The owners want to be paid. Oh, you're kidding me. Well, Lynn says it justifying why it's called petrol or diesel as opposed to gas, because it sounds like it's what you fill your hot air balloons with. So.
Oh, that's what you fill your hot air balloons with. I have nothing but boys in my house, no girls, so that's a whole nother term for gas in my house. But that's a different conversation.
Andrew's saying ATCs equal are awfully tiny cards or artfully tiny cards.
Or artist trading cards. It could be that as well.
There was another one up here, too. I forget what they said.
All right, these, I thought these would be kind of cool for this, but they won't all work because of how big they are. So these are Creating in Faith rub-ons. Remember these rub-ons from Jamie Doherty? So they won't all fit because they're not all the right size. But look at that one with the perfect love. I like that. Let's see. You have to, like, open it. Come on. Patience, Heather. I have none.
Lynn's was saying ATCs means arty tardy community.
Oh, I'm sure there's a bunch of words that they can come up with out there as to what it means.
Now, Kim has got ATC cards and she's never used them. Oh, Kim.
What?
It is the funnest thing to do is to get into an ATC swap. It really is.
Well,
there
we're
going
to have to set one up because there's just no,
there's
just no getting around it.
Lynn's is saying ATC is Andrew's tune cards.
Oh, now you're talking.
And Aurora's saying she's in for an ATC swap.
All right, look at that. I cut this apart so that way I can use it.
Bill is saying gas is $10.80 a gallon.
Hence what I said earlier, how they have no car. Remember? I mean, why would you own a car if that's
he
how
much
it costs?
He says a mortgage broker pumped your gas.
Yeah, so, yeah, I'm never going to Belize with my car. That's obvious.
Wow.
So the Kraft Shaak Adventure Mobile cannot go to Belize. It has just been determined. Wow. Hey, how do you get these things off when you have these nails? Does anybody know?
Wow.
There we go. Got it. All right, check it. Check it. All right, so what I like to do is... When I'm doing mixed media, whether it's a big old canvas or it's a little bitty piece of this, thank you for the stick. I appreciate it. Wow. 10 points for Nikki today because she just
she was on that. She
just
was on that.
Like handed me the popsicle stick like I didn't have to move.
Woo!
All right, remember the points don't mean anything.
I know.
Okay. Just don't, making sure you're not expecting something before you leave. All right. All right. So what I like to do when I'm doing my mixed media, don't get upset if I move this. That's going to be, can you slide that back just a hair? Just a hair. So it's not touching. Yeah, it's still touching, but oh well. Hopefully that's not too bad. Is that, it's not moving the camera. It's just moving
bad.
It's just moving our monitor. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's see if I can finish the statement. Okay. What I like to do, what I like to do when I am doing mixed media is I either have a focal image or I like to have words, or sometimes you can have both. Sometimes it's just about what you put on there. You don't have to have a focal. I'm just saying these are some of the things I like. So sometimes the background and what you end up with is just enough, right? You can just let that be enough. I'm trying to see if this is working or if it's not dry enough.
No, paint's coming up.
Is it coming up?
Mm-hmm.
That's fascinating. I don't think I dried the... It's not dry
Bill
enough.
Is saying that it was perfect timing. He licked the last of the ice cream off the stick just in time.
Just
or maybe
in
you
time.
Did, Nikki. Yeah.
Just in time. I'm going to get it hot a little bit and see what that does. And line this up. Look, even when you mess up, you can fix it. It's no big deal. No big deal. And if this doesn't work, we have plan B and C, and it just move on. You got to not let this stuff stress you out, because seriously, this is the only day of the week that I don't stress. Well, that's not totally true, is it? But I try not to stress on this day. It's like my answer to stress here is what we do here. I don't know. If I keep talking, I'm going to dig myself a really deep hole. So I'll just be quiet because I'm sure family members want to hurt me right now. So it's not, I already know it's not releasing. So I don't even know like why. Why is it not releasing, Sylvia?
Because
it's
not completely dry.
Yeah, it's too wet.
It's
too wet. I can tell by that right there. All right, so that one's not. So plan seven.
Yeah.
Plan H. What, I don't know what letter we're on now.
You can just print it on, handwrite it on. Lynn says she's always wanted rub-ons, but she's never found any. They don't have them in the UK. They don't have them over there.
Well, I think it's like any craft item. They're hard to find. And, you know, rub-ons, they had a little surge of a comeback recently, but I haven't seen them in a while. These are left over from when we had the store. That's a few years ago. So none of these are dry enough to do this to. None of them.
Okay,
so I have to wait.
Then we will, you know, move on to
all
something
else. All
right,
plan nine. That's all right. I got this because I have this huge bin of stuff over here that nobody else can see. But I got this huge bin of stuff that I've been saving for moments like these. Moments just like these. So here's one. Let's see what we can do with this. These are stickers. Stickers you can't go wrong with, because stickers, even if they lose their stick-em, you can glue them.
Right.
And even if you can't get them off the stick-em thing. Oh, which reminds me, I was going to do something else, so hang on. Remember, I was going to do these things? Remember these things?
And Freedom's saying, you know, if that rub-on doesn't work, you know, I staple it to the ATC and let it be a transparency.
Genius. I like that. So these are those labels that I showed at the beginning that I had jelly plated, these labels. Look at, you can add those to them. That's cool, right?
Uh-huh.
I'm trying to pick ones that don't have the, like, my address showing, because I didn't get to finish them all. Like, I'm being specific about which ones I add. That's cool. See these? That's really cool, right? These need a little pop of varying color on them, I think. And to dry, as I just stuck my finger in goo. That's cool. Mm. And see, you can continue it on to the other side.
Lynn's is saying they don't really do a lot of craft stuff in the UK unless you pay a fortune to the TV, because they do have a cool, you know, a couple cool TV channels, but our US importers, no real craft shops. The few that they have are specialized or fatty. Oh.
Yeah, there you go. So they do struggle. I think that's how come so many UK folks asked for me to send stuff to them. I mean, it was hard. That postage, man, it's a nightmare.
Well, and then we find out that they have to pay to receive.
Yeah, even worse.
That drives me nuts.
Yeah, it's not enough that they paid a ridiculous amount of shipping to the seller, who isn't pocketing that, by the way. The shipping came from, or covers the postage only.
Yeah.
It's not like I was making a profit on any of that. As a matter of fact, I lost a ton of money. That was the whole reason why we shut down, because it just cost us way too much money. I just like putting these little bits of pieces here and there. That's kind of neat, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Okay. All right. I've done enough of that, right? So you get the idea. Wait. No, I lied to you. There's one more. Just one.
Although Lynn's is saying they do have sequins in the pound shop. I don't know what the pound shop means, but
dollar store. Yeah.
So
that explains the picture she posted earlier. Then, yeah, for sure.
I don't know if you've read my responses, Lynn's, but I came up with quite
she
a
had
few,
some
so.
She had some great ideas and was actually kind of irritated with the rest of us because we basically copied her. Oh, I like that. That's pretty neat. Okay, so that's going to have this, I think, if it'll work. So this says, you deserve a big thanks for all the good times and memories. And you could just put that on top of there, but we're not going to do that. That would be boring. Way too simple. You know I need to be complicated, right? So I'm cutting off the big thanks with my very messy fingers. And I'm cutting it right to the edge, so it's really going to be just
this. Oh, Jazzy's here, and she's saying, I like how Heather's showing all these neat options.
I'm so glad to see Jazzy. I haven't seen her in a while. Yeah, this is the one I want. Right there.
Can you read it?
Yeah, I can. But that's not the end of it, so... Now, this is where I was going earlier when I was explaining. Guess who's getting a foot cramp again? This is where I was going earlier when I was explaining what I wanted to do with mixed media. I always have a focal point or image or both. Either it's like focal point image or words or both. And then I always have black and white added details. So let's just... Can you ever tell when I'm a little bit like unsure about what I want to do? I do this like 45 times. Anybody else do that?
Yeah. It's called hovering.
Yeah. It's practicing. You know, I just mentioned we got to practice before we do the things we're going to do, right? I'm just practicing. Practicing whether I want to really ruin it or just sort of slightly ruin it. But we had already said it's mixed media. You're not ruining anything, right?
Right. Oh, that actually made it pop.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
It's hard to see with this with the image so far away, but hopefully when I bring it up, you'll be able to see it a little better. So I'm focusing on the left side for everything. And then depending on... Oh, you got to see what you're doing, Heather. Depending on where I... can't write and talk at the same time. Where I think it needs to go after that, I might do like the bottoms of all of them. But you have to concentrate. Oh, that's too funny. All right, so let's go. Meanwhile, left foot cramping again.
Hold that up to the camera so they can see
that. I picked the one marker that wouldn't quite work.
See how cool that is? Wow. Very good.
Look at that.
Oh, look at that
shimmer.
Isn't that
neat?
Yeah.
That's cool. So choose, these are all, it looks like these are all, what do you call that? Like vellum stickers? Vellum, yeah? Mm-hmm. That's the word. And so they're going to be a little bit see-through. Oh, you make me a better person. I don't want to lie to anybody, so I'm not going to use that. Just kidding. Oh, here's one. This one I was going to use.
There you go.
Don't even have to do anything to that one. Done.
Okay, Kim is saying that her dollar store is going out of business, and she got a bunch of bottles of beads with glue already in the bottles.
Oh.
I've never heard that.
That's
I've
neat.
Never heard that. I have bottles, I have beads, I have glue. Sort of like getting iced coffee, huh, Heather?
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness.
So Heather and I are that was in Montreal, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was on the way home from Montreal.
Right, on the way home from Montreal when we went to see Cece. And
Lucy and Sam.
And, yeah, Lucy and Sam and... We're in the airport, and I'm dying for some iced coffee. I'm just dying for some. So we stop in this restaurant, and I said, I'd like some iced coffee. And the guy says, we don't do that.
Oh, no, you didn't do it right. No,
I didn't do it right.
He said, no, ma'am, we do not have iced coffee.
Okay, you be the guy. I say, okay, you don't have iced coffee?
No, ma'am, we do not have iced coffee.
Do you have ice?
Yeah, we have ice.
Can you bring me a glass of ice?
Yes, I can bring you a glass of ice.
Do you have coffee?
Oh, yes, we have coffee.
Can you bring me a cup of coffee?
Yes, I can bring you a cup of coffee.
Okay, that will be my order. Thank you.
And she's not exaggerating at all.
Yeah, we do not do that. It's just like, really?
And then he walked away, and if I could have do the face cam right now, the look on her face was like, oh, you guys are missing out on the light in the
oh my gosh
on the video feed, but I'm telling you, that was hilarious. Man, it was hilarious. Okay, what else we got? So these ones. Yeah. All right, this one's never going to dry, it seems like. Look at that. I want to show it. You see how it's like all creamy white there? But then can you see that I don't know if you guys could see that or not. It's starting to crackle. Probably not because I'm too close to the thing there. You guys see it?
Oh.
So you got to let it, you got to just let it be sometimes. That one we're going to let it be, okay?
Oh, that's going to take a while to crack.
It's already started, but.
Oh. Can you see that, Nikki? Yeah. Yeah.
Colors that.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Transparent paper, really.
All right, I'm trying to get this. There we go. I'm going to put this one right here. It says faith, family, friends. And then I'm going to get out, yeah, because I want to do it on almost all of these. Pretty sure all of these will work. Look at that. It had a theme going. Didn't even realize. Cute.
Very cute.
All right, we're going to put all these down like so.
Undo perfect
love.
The only one
that's missing is this one, but I really like that idea. I wish I had a stapler handy. I don't have one.
I don't have one.
The only stapler I have is like buried in all my office stuff in the motorhome, so that's not going to happen today. But imagine, just use your picture this, if you will, like Sophia.
Use your imagination, please, for once, Sophia. Do it.
Yeah.
Okay. There you
right.
Go.
All right. Good.
I hear it.
Stapled
I hear it.
On. Okay. And then, yeah. The next thing is, because I was just told that we are just about out of time.
Look how cute. Look how cute.
Do you happen to know?
Kim's going glue.
Yeah, I could glue it. You're right.
Yeah, but staple would be cool because it adds a little dimension and texture too. So.
Yeah. Yeah. What she said. All right. I'm not finding. My white, or I mean my black. I have my
double
white
sticky tape. True, matte medium. True.
Yep, I agree with all that. We're not doing it though, because then I have to wait for it to dry. At this point,
Lynn's is going. Another thing America has I really want is bread tags. I see all these cool things to do with bread tags. Not a thing in the UK, honey. I'll send you all my bread tags. I had a cupboard before I moved just filled with bread tags. Because they're so much better than the twisties. The twisties get so wonky.
Okay, you know what? I can't do this because mentally, I can't let it go. Like, I can't release it.
What is that? Is that paint or what? What is that?
Yeah, it's really thinned out paint. Oh, my word. I'm trying to put the
cap. Do you want me to do that?
Do you want to?
Yeah, I'll do it. You can go on to something else because we're
gravy sauce.
We're at the hour.
Yeah,
we're
and we have to be done. And you know why we have to be done? Because we are limited on our hotspot usage. And we don't want to have another episode like we did last time. So, there we go.
Oh, I use splatter. Oh, I love splatters. Mm-hmm. I think splatters just finish things off.
Yeah, and I usually like black or white or sometimes both. Why not? Life is good. Use both. And when you use this like skinny little brush like that, a little bit of water with your watered down acrylic paints. Yeah. I'm going over the top of that even. I am. That needs a little more. There it is. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Bill is going... Bread tags? I thought they were guitar picks.
What?
Yes, they are.
What are bread tags and guitar picks? What the world are we talking about? What did I miss? I stepped away for 2 seconds.
Oh, that's funny.
Do you guys have any idea?
I guess that would work. They're plastic, yeah.
Seriously, where's my black? Right in front of me. Oh, this isn't black either. This is really dark blue. Ooh, that just exploded everywhere.
That'll work.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. I only work in black or really, 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 really dark gray. What is that from, T? Batman. I should have known.
Really, really black or gray.
Oh my goodness. That's awesome. Yeah. Sometimes just the flicking is enjoyable. I'm having a very good time with this right now. I'm sorry if it's not what you wanted to be watching. Tune into a different show.
This is saying she saw somebody make a fantastic necklace with bread tags. Really?
Wow.
Interesting.
I don't even know what she's talking about. I have no clue what bread tags even are.
Well, you know what blood tags are. The plastic things that hold the...
What? Oh my gosh, that immediately goes in the trash. I don't even keep it on my bread. That's what the heel of the bread is for, is to keep the rest of the bread fresh.
Yeah, but you have to close the bag.
Well, I close the bag and tuck it under. Duh.
Oh, no.
Twisties. Uh-uh. That's too hard to get into.
Bread is tied with a tie.
Yeah, I have those.
I take that off and I put the tag on because I can't stand using those ties.
I hate those plastic tags. I can't stand using those plastic. No, that's garbage.
Okay. Start putting them in a plastic bag.
Yeah, I'm sending them to her Lynn's,
obviously. To Lynn's, and she'll think that she had a stash of glitter. Wait till she gets everybody's bread tags.
Yeah, between sequins and bread tags, Lynn's is never going to go wrong.
Yeah.
They're making all kinds of jewelry.
Okay, so this is pretty much the end of my mixed media adventure with playing cards. You could do the other side if you want to, if you have another hour to kill. Just saying, I love the colors.
Yeah,
they're not totally dry, but they're dry enough to give a look, right?
Yeah.
You can see this is going to be crackled. I don't know if you guys can tell, it's starting to crackle already. Pretty big cracks going on there, but you probably can't see it. It won't focus. That one.
Bill is saying that his mom had to twist it and fold it over too because he stole all of the guitar picks.
Yeah.
I think that's hysterical. I love that.
Bill, you could have been my son, although that would have been really weird. Because I would have been fine with it. I love these ones that don't have anything on them even. Those are fun. Very fun.
That's so cute. Oh, my gosh.
You could even add three-dimensional stuff to these because there's nothing saying they have to be flat or one layer. You could add, like, a crocheted flower or, you know, whatever. I like that one, too. Oh, there's some crackles in there.
Mm.
I know you want to see it. Let's see this one. I'm going to staple that so it won't fall off. That's not bad.
Liking. Yeah.
No. All right, there we go.
I love
that
shimmer.
Oh, yum. All right, you guys, we're going to call that good. What do you think? If you really like this show, give it a thumbs up. And if you only sort of like the show, give it a thumbs up anyway. And if you didn't like the show, you're going to give it a thumbs down, you better leave a comment telling me why, because it's the only way I can improve, right?
That's right.
So hopefully you enjoyed it. Hopefully we give a thumbs up. If you really, really, really liked it, share it with your friends. And don't forget, join our newsletter, and you'll hear all about the upcoming video blog hop that we're doing. You'll hear about silly little antics as I share my coffee stories in the morning. All kinds of stuff coming on there.
Coffee clutch? Is coffee clutch coming
Coffee
back?
Clutch. Oh, that's an inside joke right there. All right, so that's the end of that. This is the end of the show.
Excellent.
Thank
Very
you, Nikki,
good.
For showing up.
Thank you.
Appreciate you being here. And you know, if you're in the Mesa, Arizona area, or somewhere in Arizona you want to travel to Mesa, send me a little message and we'll talk. I might tell you where we are so you could come join us. But we're working on. Oh, I gotta say this before we leave.
Yeah,
we're working on doing an art concert here in Arizona.
Yes, we are. Woo!
Yeah. So we go check that out this week. We'll tell you all about that again in the newsletter. Thank you, T-Dog, for helping out with all of the behind the scenes.
Yes, and T-Dog does an awesome job.
Thanks, everybody, for joining us live and for joining the recording if you are doing so. Thanks, everybody. Have a crafty day. Bye-bye.
Bye, all.